Hello there. We're here in Shinagh Dairy Farm, as you know, just north of Bandon in County Cork. We're in the same situation as most people out there are at the moment. We're tight for grass. What you're looking at behind us here is we're unfortunately having to graze second cut silage, but very glad that it's available on the platform to graze it. We're putting in more and more feed, so we are at 6.5 kilos inside in the parlour, being fed, you know, after morning milking, during evening milking. And on top of that, we've been lucky enough to source palm kernel meal, and maybe we'll come back to the usefulness of palm kernel later, but palm kernel is a high fibre ration, obviously coming from the Middle East. Where it's very useful is cows will not gorge themselves on it, so they're not going to be any stomach upsets. So we're feeding that outside of the milking times in ordinary troughs in the yard. We've even used some of it where we fed it in round feeders, the same as you would silage. So it's high fibre. Our objective is to try to spare what we've out here. So our diet at the minute is about a third ration through the parlour, about a third of palm kernel, and a third of what's left out here. Like, at the moment, we're okay, but like everyone, unless we get rain, we're running out rapidly. We're trying to hold our rotation length out there at around 20, 25 days. We'd rather stay out of the 25 days because it's given the ground a bit more chance to come back. What you're looking at in this shot is it's a bit greener than normal because, as I said, this was second cut silage with a cover up on it of about 1500, so it was a bit greener than normal. Just to say, like, what they're doing, unfortunately it's costing a lot obviously to produce this milk, but we're very happy how they're milking. So I'm just checking here, they're doing 18.5 litres at the moment at 4.36 fat and a super 3.72% protein. So they're pumping out 1.54 kilos of milk solids a day at the minute. We're happy with it. We're obviously not happy how much it's costing us, but we are where we are. So some of the principles we are using that are probably applicable to anyone out there. You're trying to hold rotation length. So to do that, you have to put in enough feed to do it. So, okay, you maximise out what you can feed in the parlour. We've no problem of going to 6.5, 7 kilos. To me, once I'm at 7, that's my limit, because I'm 7 obviously fed twice a day. You're concerned that you could cause stomach upsets. So you're watching cows' dungs. If the dungs are getting too loose, it's an indication that the rumen isn't working perfect and you would back off of the amount of ration they're getting. So we're at 7 kilos now, we said, fed twice a day in the parlour, that's your maximum. You still now need to spare your grass. If you can source alternative forages, that's grand, but just be careful, a lot of these alternative forages are starting to get expensive compared to the like of a simple mix from your co-op. Or even better again, if they can give you something like palm kernel or soya hulls, because these are high fibre products and you can feed them, you can feed the palm kernel very safely. You have to be a bit more careful with the soya hulls, but you can push the amount of feed of those going in up to 5 kilos a day. So now you're ended up back very much like where we are here at the minute. A third of their feed is coming from your standard in parlour feed. A third is coming from some other feed that you're feeding outside of the parlour at some time after milking or before milking in the middle of the day or again that evening. And then a lot of people are only letting cows out at night to do the grazing. So you're sparing out grass to hold your rotation length. Those are good sort of principles that anyone can use.